muž kaže, kad me vozi, on ka, ovaj, ne pušu. A on kaže, pa što ne pališ, ko te kada kaže.
Hey Sophie. A gledaj u dedu malo da te snimam. Da vidim kako si mi lepa. Aha. Young lady. Znamo mi nju.
Ako ne znam.
Ste nekada bila tamo?
Velik. Pa kako nije bila, skoro je spavala tamo.
U staroj kući. Think of anything else that could happen.
What could it have been?
Thank you.
Jesu vašu svadbu snimili? Pa što nisi zvala Zorana?
Absolutely delighted and honored to host Millie and Andrew's special day and to have you all here. We cannot think of a better ways to use and enjoy Oak Hill. I know many of you are here for the hunt on Sunday with So and Millie and Andrew.
Maybe!
We wanted to mention we've given Millie and Andrew carte blanche to rearrange things as at Oak Hill as they see fit, So if one or two things are out of place, just put it down to English eccentricity. The groom's penchant for the dramatic. And the bride's ever-present desire to ensure that all are made content with food, drink, and entertainment. It has become something of a tradition in our family to create and recite limericks to initiate the fêting at family birthdays and special gatherings. Over the years, these have tended to veer off towards the body, such that there is trepidation at every turn, even when our octogenarian members rise to deliver. Fortunately, the children do get older and presumably less sensitized to off-color remarks, questions of proclivity and suggestions, innuendo be damned, that usually involve a horse in some shape, fashion, or compromising position. So starting things off. There was a fine young man from Cheshire, known the world over as a very snappy dresser. He had set his heart on hunting as his chosen vocation, a labor of love entailing much application, migration and acclimation in a far-off nation. We need not dwell on the myriad gyrations required to ensure that the absolute necessity was acquired. Suffice it to say, every fox has his day. And in the capable hands of this well-trained gilly, at the end of the day, he has secured his prize, the finest of fillies, Millie! Hamilton's loss was Montreal's great gain, and we are very happy to have been part and parcel by the means by which the natural course of events have progressed to where we find ourselves today. We are proud as a family of the collective conspiracies, Project Sparkle being one that comes to mind. We are desperately fond of them both, which is highly unusual. You know, there is always one of the pair you are more fond of. In my case, I realize it's a tough call, darling. But we can honestly say we love you both equally. Millie and Andrew are a great match, well-twinned, or shall we always say well-tweed, whatever the occasion. They have exhibited and exemplified many of those qualities towards each other that will stand them in good stead. Calmness, understanding, compassion, and a propensity to answer, yes, dear, to any query or command, for that matter. Their dedication to each other is amply matched by their dedication to their chosen vocation. Their care and concern for their horses, hounds, and puppies is legend. Everyone in the hunt field appreciates Andrew's command of the sport, his excellent working relationship with his hounds, along with his realization that hunting is also a spectacle for the entertainment of the field. The standing stirrup ovation at the last Beaver Meadow Festival was as impromptu as it was sincere. Millie's expert care and support is always there. As they say, behind every great man stands an even greater woman. We wish them nothing but the best, health and happiness to come, and tanti bambini. Just not during the hunt season. Please join me in raising a glass to the best of gillies and fillies, Andrew and Millie.
And our next comedian on stage, following the next course will be Hank Martin. See you then. Tell you about a very quick story about the first time I met Millie's dad. So the first time I meet Millie's dad, he says, "Oh, sit." I'm like, "Oh, I better sit." Yeah? And then he gets out this Schliebovitz. He says, "Now drink." So I had a drink, and then he pours another one. He says, "Drink." So I'm kind of scared of him, and I'm like, "Okay, I'll drink." Then he pours another one. And I said, "How many of these do I have to drink?" He says, "I don't know, how many can I make you drink?" So he tells me about this guy, Andrew, that comes and sits down in front of him, and he says, this guy's, he's kind of nervous, and he's sitting there, he's rubbing his hands, and he's looking all nervous, and he kind of had a feeling of what was going on. So he says to him, "Okay, you have something to say, you just spit it out." And Andrew says, "You know, I would like to marry your daughter." And Peter pauses for a minute, and he says, "You know what? Call me in a week, I'll give you my answer."
True story.
This is a true story. So I said,
yeah. So 12 days.
It was actually 12 days, it wasn't even a week. "Call me when you get home from vacation, I'll give you my answer." So, so I said to Peter, I said, "So what's your thinking like? What do you think?" And he says, "Well, you know, I'm a realist. He says, you know, Millie's getting old, so she'll expire, I'll keep her forever. So I need her to go somewhere. This guy seems okay. And he was polite enough to come and ask me, but he seemed pretty eager. And I thought, well, is that a bad thing? He says, no, but somebody that eager, if I put him off, maybe I'll get something extra. So with that in mind, Soyana came home. Peter fills her in on his strategy, and she smacked him about 5 times and made Peter call him. So that's kind of my first time I met Peter, and at that point I understood how Millie is the way she is. So Hank, Marren, you're next on stage.
Pretty hard act to follow. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, let me say how delighted we, the table here and somewhere else, of the former Hamilton Hunt supporters that followed Andrew to Montreal are delighted and honored to be here.
You're here.
Now, I'm just going to move quickly into the hunting vein. The tragedy of all huntsmen usually is in the hunt field when either the hounds won't follow, they can't find, or they find and it's a riot. And this is very bad because people get bunned off, the whips get blamed, Millie, and we all know, we all been there. So in light of that fact, and looking at new technology, we thought we found something that might help. Now, this is a device designed to either mitigate a riot or help the hounds find when, you know, it's a hot day, everything's going bad and slow, nobody can find, the field is getting discontent. So, with that in mind, we found a device here that we'll call Quarry for the hounds, or switch them on to an alternate quarry if there's a riot. Now this device will look after cougar, gray wolf, loons. If you want a loon, I mean, what better quarry than a loon if you're on a riot? You get that loon in there.
Well, we did hunt a bear.
Yeah, and we have a bear call here for that bear who's misbehaving, and you know, you need to draw him up. And finally, let's see. American Eagle. Being close to Vermont and so forth, you know, you might need that. And finally, in addition to the black bear, a grizzly bear, which probably won't have to worry about here, but it might confuse the hounds enough to get them back. So, without further ado, Andrew and Billy, we have this little device, and please use it wisely.
Okay, everybody, enjoy your main course. There will only be one more speech after this. Eat on.
Thank you.
one.
I'll be the chief.
You're not chief of the
bar. I must be doing something right, because I just met this giant Serbian guy in the washroom. He cornered me and said, "You were going to be my best man, yeah?" Millie and Andrew enter our lives in numerous ways that affect us all. Millie, with her wonderful cooking, artwork, and funny one-liners, stay with us in our bellies, our homes, and our hearts. Andrew, with his cheery calls, interesting wardrobe, and unique style of having fun, will also stay in our minds, our closets, and hopefully not in prison. Andrew and Millie, you're both very unique, and finding each other was by chance. Everyone in the room that knows either one of you knows the unique persons that you are, and the loving, fun-filled hearts you both have. My wife Mary, my daughter Bink, and I, we love you both. From the bottom of our hearts, we do. And we'd like to take this opportunity to make another cheers from all of us for this great event. Cheers! That was just a general cheers. We have three quick ones now and then we're done. Let's raise a glass to Millie herself. Millie, you're beautiful today as every day. Cheers, Millie! We'll raise a glass to Andrew. Andrew, thank you very much. Oh, and at the pause. Andrew needs a glass. I know, we're waiting. Usually we're waiting for his brother. Today we're waiting for him.
I should not have a glass all night.
Okay, everyone, we'll raise a glass to Andrew. Andrew, thank you for all the wardrobe advice. Cheers! And finally, to Andrew and Millie, and the future health of everyone in the room, cheers and thank you very much.
Sorry, I haven't prepared anything for tonight because I thought I'd see how it went. A million people were congratulating me at 10 to 3 and I said, well, you can't congratulate me until she turns up. But everyone did congratulate me. All I want to do tonight is not tell funny stories about Peter and how he tortured me, or not tell Blaine about how I give him great advice on wardrobe and then he turns up looking like
he does.
It's basically just thank yous. I tried to remember when we were having supper about the saying that it takes a village to raise a child, but I can't remember what it was. I'd had far too much red wine. But, you know,
it takes two countries to raise Andrew.
But everyone here tonight has touched Millie and I. We're liberal, but not that liberal. They've touched our lives in many different ways. And I just want to say thank you to everyone for coming today. You know, some of you have come a very little amount, and some people have come incredibly far. And we mean, you know, we had, we could have invited a million people, but you're the people we wanted here. So yes. I just want to say thank you so much for coming, honestly.
Thank you.
You know, where do you start thanking people? I'm probably going to miss a million people out, but obviously I have to thank my mother. You know, she, you know, birthed this amazing creature. And then I'd have to thank Millie's mother for, you know, birthing Millie, because she's so amazing. But, you know, well, start in England, that when I left the South Durham, I had a broken leg and had nowhere to live, and my good friend Olivia over there, she put me up, and until we found a job, Jenny Stafford, I remember there was two jobs available, and she said there was either go to Canada or France, and it's funny that I ended up in Quebec.
Thanks.
So I remember Jenny saying, why on earth would you want to go to Canada? You know, they probably, you know, it's all polar bears. And I think Hank must have written the description of the job, because he made it sound like, you know, we'd be in the Yukon, because there's no pubs around and life was awful. And he really saw that, you know, we decided, so, you know, that Olivia and Jenny got me over here, and then I remember Hank picking me up in the car, and Carly, I used to be the size of a broom pole until I met Carly. Carly, you know...
Don't blame Carly!
No, and I don't want to blame Carly, but I always feel bad because Carly would take me to Costco and kind of, you know, every 2 weeks and fill up my cart, and she'd always pay, and I'd always think, does Hank know about this? Because, you know, I'd always worry about his credit card because, you know, Carly was always... And, you know, I'd always lose a button and Wendy would sew it on and Maggie would take me somewhere and all the generosity of the Hamilton people, that's why you're here today. And, you know, and then when all the funny things went on at the Hamilton, Maurizio was there and saved us, you know, amazingly. We thought we may have to leave the country, and Millie said, oh, I don't know if I'd want to live in England. So, she said she would live in England, but not if I was a huntsman. So I think she likes the red coat. She's that, and that's that type of thing. So, and then it goes on, you know, when I've lived here, there's been so many people that have, you know, and now I'm looking at people like Eric and Kathy and Mary, who used to walk out the hounds with me every day at the Hamilton. All the people here in Quebec who make me, you know, feel so welcome. Philip LaMarche, I get the truck stuck in the middle of a ditch and I phone him up and say, where are you? And he comes in 2 seconds flat. You know, Heather Swan, who makes me look amazing in all the pictures. You know, but it's not all about, you know, it's amazing, you know. And for today, let's talk about today. You know, we wouldn't have done this without Millie's mother and father for helping us, you know, put this amazing event. All the people that I'm kind of like going blank now, all the people, Ken, who keeps this property amazingly, you know. Okay, Millie says I have to stop now.
No, you can thank Blaine.
You're gone.
Oh yeah, Blaine for being the best man, but Blaine's like the best. The reason why I forgot Blaine is because Blaine's like a best man every day of my life. I can just phone him up and he will organize something. So I had to say that, you know. So I'm going to end on two thank yous. I want to thank, if I've forgotten you, it's not because I don't love you. It's because I don't want to thank you, Philip. You're useless. We just tolerate you. So our main thank you, I want to do two toasts, and I have to nip away for 1 second, is we couldn't have done this today without... This whole thing started when Millie and I got engaged on holiday on a beach with Project Sparkler, when Claudia and Maurizio wrapped my engagement ring in a palm leaf and put it on a beach. And then I realized that I was walking romantically down the beach and I didn't have the engagement ring. So I said to Millie, I think we need cheese and crackers. And typical Millie says, you never need cheese and crackers. So I had to insist that we got cheese and crackers, and then she reminds me about how big I am, so we have to go there. So then I had to rush back and get the, you know, pretend I was getting cheese and crackers, and I had the ring in my pocket. And I dashed along the beach, and I realized that I didn't have the cheese and crackers, so I had to dash back again, otherwise it wouldn't have been good at all. And that's when it all started, and that night, Maurizio and Claudia offered us to have this place. Obviously, we were going to say yes, but we had to pretend that we had to think about it for a night. So I'd like everyone to stand, and we have a little present, which, you, as you can see, Maurizio and Claudia have amazing taste and everything in the world. So we can never know what to thank them, but we got them a little gift from our favorite artist, which we're going to give you now as a little thank you. It's a drop in the ocean to what Millie and I think of you and Claudia and your beautiful children. who are like family to us. So I'd like everybody to stand and raise their glass and thank Rizzo and Claudia for doing this for us.
Thank you. Cheers.
Thank you.
She's taking them in France of the wild.
Are they self-pack portraits of Andrew?
Oh. They're beautiful.
Plain.
And I'm much too high.
It's nothing. It's nothing.
We're a little, this is your day. We're a little embarrassed. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Can we see it?
Raise the glass and say thank you, Lindsay and Claudia. Thank you. I'd like to propose, and make sure your glass is really full. It's the most beautiful woman in the world who are going to be my wife.
We know who that is.
And she looks absolutely stunning. And I promise to everybody in this room, I promise to love her and look after her for eternity to the amazing Millie Marren.
Yeah!
Okay, let's do some dancing!
Stop. Thank you.
Ima bome dosta kola ovde.
Mhm.
Parkirajmo sa u stranu I da se...
Ja mogu tu jedan.
Moš.
Vidi koliko imaju zemlje. 2000 dolara ovaj, ne zemlje, to mi je rekla Stana, da imaju 2000.
Verovatno živi onaj ko vodi računa, jer on mora da... Oh my god.
Ajde, popenji se.
That's okay.
Why? So early. Come šta pričaš, yeah. Ženo?
That's okay.
Early.
Come on. Come on. Perfect timing. Perfect.
We need to hold the camera so you guys can all tell him off.
I don't care.
It must be.
I don't care.
Nice to see you guys.
Zorane. Dobro jutro. Ja sam već na radnom mjestu, kao što vidiš. E, ovo će biti fantazija, vidi ovo.
Neće.
Pa malo
kožice,
ovo za nas.
Da, da. Ima još ovdje, nismo sekli.
Ostavi smo još da nemamo da rezervu.
Znaš kako miriše kad otvoriš vrata, pečenje, wow!
Kad ste vi zapustili tamo. Koliko bilo sati kad ste vi napustili tamo?
We were home at 1:30. Pa nešto nije okolo.
Vi to malo preobali. I to imaju lek tamo dole negde.
Generacija
ovdje. Ja se javljam, a niko me ne šiša.
Pa nisam čuje, malo pre vidim Zoran priča, a ne vidim tebe.
Pa ja sam taka malecna da ne stane.
Pa nije te valjda reko ostavio Zoran kući.
Nikome ne vidim.
No, pa vidiš
ja sam... Ja, ovo je prelepo ovdje.
Beautiful.
Oh my god. Oh
znači ovo 3,5 miliona I gotovo. Pa nini skup.
A ne, znaš šta je Joe rekao? Kaže, ja bi rađe da dođem da iznajmim I da odem kući.
Da, prelepo.
Tvoji ljubimci. Ja.
Šta kažeš deda za ovo, ova kuća?
Ko će da dođe? Everybody's on it.
Really, I just want to eat the cookies and drink the wine, so... I have to get it in the house first.
Bring it all. You scared me.
But I was told, yes, and that we were graciously invited and everything, so I'm tired too, though. So go ahead.
Why are you tired?
By all means.
Thank you.
By all means.
I got a surprise for you, Millie.
What?
I watched a little bit of a tape last night.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. And I got my laptop here.
As long as you can send DVDs to Andrew's aunts and uncles and...
Is that a husband and a wife or a girlfriend? Or sister?
Boyfriend.
He's no dummy. I can tell he's no dummy. Honey, don't get them brandy if you have some, eh?
You want something in your coffee?
Maybe I'll be on it too.
Yeah.
All right. Very dear. Thank you.
Can you grab one more chair there?
Oh, wait, I can
get out. Oh, no, he's got one.
I'm going to do the edit.
I'm just going to
give
Ja mu kažem hvala, on kaže beži more. Pa dobro, ali rekao kako ćete da odete do tog. Da Ontario ima više Srba nego Čeha.
Mika!
Okay.